Hey guys, David here with plenty of great Nintendo 3DS news, and first up, we finally have the release date for Resident Evil Revelations. So the game's coming out in Europe first, it's coming out on the 27th of January 2012, and then in North America it's coming out on February 7th. And as you can see here, we have the box art for the game. It looks absolutely fantastic. It's like really, really impressive, I think. Possibly the best box art we've seen for any Nintendo 3DS game. So, good job Capcom. There is also a pretty neat pre-order bonus if you get it from GameStop in North America. What you basically get is a case for the 3DS. But what is actually very neat is if you use the case in sunlight, so if you have your 3DS out this case on, it's in the sun, it'll look different from when it's not in sunlight. And you can sort of see an example of that in this promotional image. So that's pretty cool. And like I said, that's just a pre-order bonus for pre-ordering the game from GameStop in North America, so you might want to do that. Next up, Nintendo of America has confirmed that they have a bunch more partners to deliver video content to the 3DS. The biggest partner is DreamWorks Animation. They're going to be bringing a couple of shorts to the 3DS this month. So from DreamWorks Animation, there's going to be a video relating to Monsters vs. Aliens, and also one from Shrek. There is also going to be a video from the Blue Man Group, who have those like really weird performances and that kind of stuff. So there's going to be one video from them for this month, and also three videos from 3Net, who are basically a bunch of different companies joined together who work on different series. So once again, it's all free video content via the 3DS, always pretty cool. And it's good to see Nintendo still pushing with this sort of content. Hopefully we're going to get some longer form content at some point. Next up, we have the first trailer for WWE All-Stars on the Nintendo 3DS. There's a bunch of gameplay footage in the trailer. To be honest, it doesn't look that good. Maybe if you're a fan of WWE, you'll really like it, but just on first impressions, not that impressive. Even so, you can check out the trailer if you want. Maybe you'll like it, maybe it's your type of thing. I just don't think it's really worth, you know, 30 to 40 bucks. Once again, though, that's just based on first impressions. Haven't played it, maybe it's fantastic, but eh. A much, much, much prettier video, though, is for Bravely Default Flying Fairy, which is the strangest name for a game I've ever heard. Basically, it's a traditional RPG from Square Enix, and even though I'm not, like, a fan of turn-based combat, and I really am not interested in playing the game itself, it's still very, very pretty. Like, it has to be definitely one of the prettiest games on the 3DS so far, so it's really worth checking out the video. It has a really cool art style, and it looks like it could be a really good game. I'm just not really a fan of traditional, like, Japanese RPGs. Either way, more on check it out. At the very least, it's good to see that Square Enix is putting effort into their stuff on the 3DS. And then last up, we have some screenshots from Monster Hunter Tri-G. As always, the game is looking fantastic. People keep asking me, like, is it going to be localized? We don't know. There was a rumor of it, some speculation. It could be. I think it probably will be at some point, but we really don't know at the moment, so just be patient. Either way, the screenshots, very pretty, enjoy those. And that is all the Nintendo 3DS news for now though. Make sure to check out the previous video just in case you missed that one, I know some people do. But I guess that is it for now, so I will talk to you later.